All right, so now let's take a mental snapshot of this one. So this is base 2. And again, all the same principles. In base 2, we only have a 0 and a 1. And so when we run out of digits, we do a 1 plus a 1, we have to shift out, put a 0, and then when we add 1 to that, we get the 1, 1, and then when we add 1 to that, we have to shift out 0, 0, and then 1. And it all comes down to this idea of positional value. And in fact, this will become important, these numbers right here. You'll start to get to a point where you just kind of memorize this. This is just like in decimal, you know it's the ones and then tens and 100s and 1000s and 10,000s. That comes second nature to you. But it's going to take a minute for you to remember that in binary it goes ones, twos, fours, eights. But it's pretty simple because it's always just going to be that next number divided or multiplied by 2. So 1, 2, 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 2 is 8, 8 times 2 is 16, 16 times 2 is... So that's why you'll see those numbers, you know, that it comes in those numbers. 16 gig of RAM and 32 gigabyte hard drive and 64 gigabyte hard drive and so on and so forth. Because we're always incrementing by another line on the bus, so to speak. This is going to get confusing. So as soon as we add another bit, then we've multiplied by 2 because that's how many signals we can put on the bus or store in memory or whatever it is. We've added another 2 options to that. Okay? All right, so with that kind of as an introduction, now let's look at what we call hexadecimal. All right, so hexadecimal. Meaning 16 things, base 16. Now in computers we've also dealt in octal, which is base 8. But hexadecimal works out well to be a good shorthand for binary. The problem was, if you're writing a program, which they were initially, in binary, you get a number that, you know, looks like whatever, you know, 1001111001011 or 1010. You get a number like that, and you're having to translate that. And it's so easy to make a mistake when you're working in those ones and zeros. And so at some point along the way in computing, it works out based on multiples to move to a base 16 numbering system. It becomes kind of a shortcut for filling in this binary number. So in hexadecimal, we needed to come up with 16 digits. So they started out with the initial base digits we use for decimal, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's 10 digits, but now we need 6 more. And so they could have just invented some digit. They could have just said, here, this is a asterisk. I'm not good at inventing stuff. This here, that is a lowercase t. Okay, let's put a line here. There, that symbol represents a 10. Now. And they could have done that, but they didn't. What they did was chose to use symbols that were familiar to us, and so they just kept going and they said, let's continue on with this, and I'm going to make the next number an A, and an A represents a 10, and a B, and a C, and a D, and an E, and an F. And now we have 16 numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. We've got 16 numbers now. Whenever I see an A, that represents a 10. Whenever I see a B, that represents a 11. A C is a 12, a D is a 13, an E is a 14, and a F is a 15 in decimal. And now we can represent more things at a time before we do this whole shifting, because what happens if I have an F in, where can I do this? I can erase in a second. But let's say I have an F in hexadecimal, and I add 1 onto that. Well, an F plus a 1, there's nothing else. Non dá, as we say in Portuguese. F plus a 1, we go through the exact same process that we've gone through with the other numbering systems. This number then becomes a 0, and we push out to the next column with starting again with 1. And so a 1, 0 in base 16 is the same thing as a 16 in base 10. Those are the same number of apples. It's just one person counted using tens and one person counted using 16s. Okay? Does that make sense? And so how do we figure out how much each position is worth? And by the way, it's the same thing. We can go through the same process. When I get to a 1F in base 16, and then I add 1 onto that, I go through the same process. There's no other digits available. And so I say I'm going to put a 0, carry the 1. 1 plus 1 is going to be 20. Okay? And if I get down to where I'm at a F, and I add 1, then I have to say 0, carry the 1, 0, carry the 1, 100. Okay, but then the question is, how much is 100 in base 16 worth in base 10? And this comes out to this idea of positional value. So let's look at this. Okay, so we're going to go back through the same process. I'm going to take 4 digits just to begin with. And it's going to be the same process. We take the base, 16, to its positional value, position, to the power of its position, which is a 0, which will give us a positional value. 16 to the 1, 16 to the 2, and 16 to the 3. Well, 16 to the 0, any number to the 0 is going to be a 1. So any value in this position is worth 1. 16 to the 1, that's easy. That's going to be, any value there is going to be worth 16. 16 squared gets a little more difficult, but as it turns out, you'll start to become familiar with these numbers. That's going to be a 256. 16 times 16 is 256. And then 16 cubed, 16 times 16 times 16, turns out to be 4096. And believe me, you'll get this before too long. And we could keep going, 16 to the 4 and 16 to the 5 and so on, but I won't give any numbers too big because it starts to become burdensome with the math. Okay, so what does that mean? Well, I just was trying to figure out how much 100 in base 16 is worth in base 10. So let's put a 100 in here. And I have 0 ones, I have 0 16s, but I have 1 256. So 100 in base 16 is the same thing as 256 in base 10. It's the same number of apples laying on the table. It's just different ways of counting it. Okay? Does that make sense? You can't answer, so I'm hoping yes. But that's the hexadecimal numbering system. It works exactly the same as the decimal and the binary numbering system, but there's advantages to doing stuff in hexadecimal that we'll begin to see as we go through and look at the equivalence and then go through the conversions between the numbering systems, which we do a lot when we're working with these numbers. It's helpful to kind of just be able to do these in your head, which you'll get to a point where you'll be able to do it. So anyway, that is the hexadecimal numbering system. We'll start working on the math coming up in the conversions in the next video. Spencer out.